Right. So in the last lecture, we have seen how UI Automator Viewer works in identifying the objects. Okay. So in this lecture, let's start with actual automation. Right. So we are on API demos page. So our test case here is to click on preference. We'll start with a basic test by seeing how to identify the objects in mobile. I'll click on preferences and then click on preference dependencies, and I would select Wi-Fi, and here it comes Wi-Fi settings, right? I want to select Wi-Fi settings and then I want to provide some name and click on OK. So this end to end I need to automate. This is my test case. Okay. So let's see how can we achieve this. Okay, this is our homepage, API demos. So for the first thing, what you need to know is to identify the objects, as discussed in the last lecture, you need to mostly depend upon XPath ID and class name Android UI Automator. So these are the object locators which you can, you know, mostly use with Appium. So the remaining also works, but not as consistent, as stable as these four locators. So I would recommend you to stick to only these four whenever you are working to identify objects. Right. Now, how to identify an object using an XPath? First of all, how to get an XPath from this UI Automator Viewer? Right. For example, let me select preference. Okay. So when I select preference, these are my details related to preference. This is the index, text, resource ID, class, package. Okay. So now from these details, how can you generate XPath is the question, right? So it's very simple. So just remember this. So if you have already familiar with Selenium, then you would have known how to write an XPath. If you are not familiar, it's still okay. So the syntax for defining XPath, let me write. XPath syntax // tag name at the rate of attribute equals to value. Right. This is how you need to provide an XPath. Okay. So if you go back, it says attribute, right? So the attribute, in the sense, for this preference object, these are the attributes: text, resource ID, class, package, and contact description, checkable. All these are attributes. Okay. But these are the core attributes to identify it. These are, you know, regular mobile related attributes which would be common to all the objects. So you cannot identify just with this clickable, enabled. Okay, these are Appium related features. But to identify an object, so package, class, resource ID, text, index, these are the core attributes for this preference. Okay, so you would need to pick one attribute, let's say class or package, and you need to write a value of that attribute. These are the values for these attributes. Here, text is an attribute, and the value of that attribute is preference, and resource ID is an attribute, and value is this one, Android ID / text one. So you need to pick one attribute, right, to identify it. And what is tag name? So the tag name in mobile is a little bit tricky. In the web, it's easy to identify when it starts with, you know, something like this symbol, you could easily identify the tag name. But here, I can tell you one trick to get the tag name. So your class name will be the tag name. Simple. Okay. So this is your tag, actually. So when you highlight this, ninth here, this is getting highlighted, right? Text view. This is your tag name. But you cannot just give text view. You need to provide android.widget.textview. So simple, you know, logic you can remember is, your class name can serve as a tag name. Okay. So you can just simply say text view as a tag name, but you need to know that prefix also, like android.widget or whatever it is. So that information, you need not worry how to get it. Just go and see your class name, and this will also serve as a purpose of your tag name. Perfect. Now we have everything. We know tag name, we know attribute, we know values. Then why should we be late? Let's start and build an XPath to identify preference, and we will try to click on it. Okay. Right. So basically we are identifying this preference point in this mobile using XPath. XPath is nothing but, if you most of the guys has been known already, but still I want to repeat that. XPath is an address to identify an element in web or mobile. Okay. So all your code, total the code you have written in that page will be in the format of XML. Okay. So XPath can read that XML and point out to specific location. Right. So preference is one point in my mobile page. Preference is one object. So with an XPath, I can find the address of that preference. Okay. So when I give in my Appium script, go to this XPath, automatically control comes here with the help of XPath. Thereafter, if you want to click or if you want to tap or if you want to zoom, whatever, you need to provide the operation there so that it does perform there. Right. Let's see how can we do that. So driver dot. So what you need to do? Basically, you need to find an element with an XPath, right? So you can simply check for find element by XPath. Okay. So what is the XPath? Now let's build XPath using this syntax. Let me write down it here. So driver dot find element by XPath slash slash. And the tag name, I have given a trick. You can take a class name which serves as a tag name. Slash slash. But sometimes it may not be always a class name. 99% of the cases. For that, you can just compare this tag name. If text view is the part of this class name, then you can use it. At the rate now. Selecting an attribute is a challenging thing. Why? If you see here, move your, this is the class and this is the package, right? And this is resource ID. Okay, just have a glance in these three. And I'll click on OS. Still the same. Click on NFC. Still the same. So all these list options have same resource ID, same class, same package. Now, if you give an attribute as a package or resource ID, how would Appium know to click on this preference? Okay, if there are 10 options with the same class, and if you ask as a class or a package an attribute to identify it, and XPath cannot identify it, it says that I have 10 in my page, I would give you the first result. So accessibility is the first result, and that will take the click, not this preference. Okay, when XPath gets multiple results with the result, it will automatically pick the first result. So first result will be somewhere this accessibility. But you need a preference. So package, class and resource ID, you cannot use this because they are common for a lot of things. But if you observe carefully, text is changing. Okay, so OS it is different. So for every option, text is differing. So text is a unique attribute you can use to identify the preference XPath, right? Isn't it? It changes. That's it. So at the rate, we use attribute as a text. Text equals to, and what's that? Preference. Okay. So this step identified your preference object with the help of XPath. That's what we are saying, right? Driver, which is an object of the entire mobile, go and identify the element with this XPath. Once it is identified, what you need to do, what operation you need to perform in this preference option. I want to click on it, right? Say dot, and you will get lot of options here. Just select click, that's it. And when you run this program, it opens the mobile or app which we have seen in the previous lecture till here, and then it identifies this preference and it will click on that. Okay, so let's see that how it's happening. So make sure your server is started and it's listening this port. Okay, and then run as Java application. Click on OK. Let me go back and see the logs. Right. So you can see the logs parallelly. You can see the emulator starting. You see that it selected and it clicked on preferences. Did you see that? We are in this page. It successfully clicked on these preferences and we reached this page. Did you identify? And you see the logs. Please make a habit of reading the logs. You should understand if there is any error by going through this Appium logs. It says got data from client. Client in the sense our code. It's an action. What action it's we are asking? Click. We are asking to click on an element with this XPath. Okay, this is an our XPath. Finding Android widget text preference. So this code has identified the element. And from this command, we are asking to click on it. That's what it is saying. Got command action click, returning result, value true. That means it successfully clicked on it. So it's responding to us with result true and 200 green success. Okay, so this is how, you know, you can work on it. And you see here carefully, valid locator strategies for this request are XPath, ID, class name, accessibility ID, Android UI automator. So this is what I'm saying. We have seen XPath, right? So in the next lecture, we would see how to deal with ID, class name, accessibility, and Android UI automator as well, right? See, that's it. That's your first step in executing the Appium and going to the other page in a mobile. In the next lecture, let's continue our test case and get deep into our program. Okay, thank you.